Hello viewers, welcome to this video. In this video, we will discuss syllabus of surveying for diploma courses. Let's begin. So here, the subject code of this subject is DTCE 301. And the subject name is survey. This subject contains 3 credit and 3 lecture. Three lecture delivered weekly, and the credit 3 will be impact in your mark sheet for final assessment. Objective of this subject as given: you will be able to understand various surveying instrument, how they are performed, what are those, how they will work on field, what are the advantages and disadvantages of these instruments will be covered in this subject. Linear and angular measurement. For example, Earth is in irregular shape or elliptical shape. The atmosphere is above the Earth's surface. We can say this atmosphere is parallel to the Earth's surface. So, if you are making an angular observation on the surface of Earth, let's take the nomenclature 0.1 and 0.2. If you are finding the angle between P1 and P2 on the Earth's surface, then the angle will be known as linear angle. Where if you are suppose at the point P2, there is a mobile tower. So now you are finding the angle suspended by the top of mobile tower to the point P1. This angle is known as vertical angle. Move to the third objective, which is measurement of area of land. You will find how to measure land, how to measure area, how to measure volume of a certain land. Prepare layout and maps. Setting out of alignment of rails, roads, canals, pipelines, tunnels and etc. All civil engineering projects required surveying before starting the construction phase, and for that we set our alignment of these projects. Alignment of these so that the feasible routes can be found. Objective number 6 is very important, where we prepare our contour maps. These contour maps are useful to find alignment, area and volume of land. Alignment of project, which is stated in 0.5, area and volume of land, which is stated on point number 7. So these are the objective of your subject. Now come to the unit 1 containing 4 lectures, and it is the basic of survey. Definition, objective of survey, principle of survey will cover in this unit, and also the type of classification of survey based on primary and secondary. So this is the unit 1 topics we will cover in separate. Unit 2 contained 8 lectures, and this is related to your chain and cross staff survey. So chain is used for linear measurements. जहाँ पे आपको लीनियर मेजरमेंट्स करना है वहाँ पे आपको चेन एंड टेप्स की जरूरत पड़ेगी. क्रॉस स्टाफ सर्वे से भी आप लीनियर मेजरमेंट कर सकते हैं. क्रॉस स्टाफ इज रिलेटेड टू योर स्टीडिया मैकेनिज्म. वी विल डिस्कस दिस व्हेन वी गो ऑन यूनिट सेकंड. सो इन दिस यूनिट सेकंड देयर आर सम गुड टॉपिक्स विच आर हाईलाइट्स फॉर यू लाइक प्रिंसिपल ऑफ chain surveying, instrument of linear measurements, chaining, triangulation is very important, errors in chains and survey, and how to apply corrections to remove those errors is also covered in unit 2. And last, which is purely application portion, that how to maintain your field book. Field book is just like your experiment notebook where you put all your details of your surveying work. Unit 3, which contain 12 lecture. This is very lengthy unit as compared to the lecture delivery. And this unit is related to compass survey. Compass surveying is related to your angles. And this angles, if we are put angles plus direction, then this term is known as bearing. I write this into another. Angle plus direction is equal to bearing. Okay, so this bearing definition will cover when we go to the unit 3. And the important topics in unit 3 is bearing of line, foreback and back bearing, whole circle bearing, quadrant bearing. These all are very important. All the topics are very important, but I am highlighting those topics which need your keen attention. Traversing and local attractions. Okay, so these are the very important topic. Even the prismatic compass is a type of compass. Also, there are two type of compass which we will study in this. So we will move to unit 4. Unit 4 contain 16 tutorial, and this unit is related to unit 4 containing leveling topics. Okay, so in this leveling, what you will able to understand, you will able to understand the location of point in vertical plane. Come to the first example where we have drawn earth. If we are measuring on the earth surface, anything measuring on earth surface like this, these are the points. So this measurement is known as linear measurement, and the art by which we are identify these points is known as surveying. But when we move to vertical plane is the plane which is perpendicular to horizontal plane. Suppose at this point the tangent plane which is parallel to the earth surface, this is your horizontal plane. Now what is the vertical plane? Vertical plane which is perpendicular to this horizontal plane. This is known as vertical plane. So in this vertical plane, there are certain points. To find the relative position of these points in vertical plane is known as leveling. So when we move to the unit 4, we will discuss these things in broad way. So the main topics we'll cover in this leveling will be level surface, or the definition of level surface, level line, horizontal line, vertical line, datum surface. These all are related to our definition point of view. If you understand these terminology, so you will be easy to cope up with these topics. Types of dumpy level, leveling star, four side and back side, we already covered in the unit 3rd in terms of bearing. Checkpoints, height of collimation, fundamental axis. These all are the important. I am not highlighting, but these are the important points as terms of definition. At least you know what is the meaning of these points. And at the last, we will go with fly leveling and check leveling. These are the important, which is used for application purpose. These are used for application, which you able to work in field. जो आप फील्ड में काम करोगे वो ये दो चीजें हैं जिसमें आप सेक्शनल फ्लाई एंड चेक लेवलिंग के ऊपर जब आप परफॉर्म कर रहे होंगे तो आपको ये चीज करना होगा, या कोई भी इंजीनियरिंग प्रोजेक्ट होगा तो उसमें आपको ये सारी चीजें ध्यान देनी होगी कि फ्लाई लेवलिंग कब करनी है, चेक लेवलिंग कब करनी है एंड सेक्शनल लेवलिंग कब करनी है. सो दिस पोर्शन इज योर रिलेटेड टू योर फील्ड वर्क. Next unit is unit 5th, which containing 4 lecture. In this we are able to understand what its definition and its maps. Contour sheets bana ke hum kya karte hain, map karte hain. To ye hum log unit 5th mein padhenge. And the last unit is unit 6, which is again related to 4 lecture. And this unit is related to your computational area and volume of earthwork. आपको इस यूनिट में ये कैलकुलेट करना है कि अर्थवर्क का एरिया, लैंड का एरिया और जो सॉइल है या आपके बोल्डर्स हैं उसका वॉल्यूम कितना होता है और कैसे हम उसे कैलकुलेट करते हैं, तो वो आपका यूनिट 6 में होगा. फॉर दिस पर्पस वी हैव सर्टेन मेथड्स नोन एज ट्रेपेजॉइडल एंड प्रिज्मॉइडल फॉर्मूला ऑन बेस जिसके ऊपर आपको न्यूमेरिकल करने होते हैं, बट आपके सिलेबस में न्यूमेरिकल नहीं, तो हम इसका इंट्रोडक्शन पोर्शन यहाँ पे क्लियर करेंगे, विच इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. द सेकेंड टॉपिक ऑफ दिस वीडियो लेक्चर इज नेम ऑफ बुक्स विच विल हेल्प यू टू डील विद दिस सब्जेक्ट. द फर्स्ट बुक इज लेवलिंग बाई NN बसक. It is very important. Surveying and Leveling. The full name of this book is Surveying and Leveling by NN Basak. For diploma courses, this book is very, very helpful. Every question in competitive exam came from this book only. So I personally refer you to please purchase this book. This is very handy book, not too much thickness and very easy language. The second book is Surveying and Leveling Part 1 and Part 2 by Karnetkar and Kulkarni. Third book is similarly Surveying and Leveling Volume 1 and Volume 2 by B.C. Punia. These top 3 books for your surveying course, I recommend you that purchase any one of these 3 books. The another 3 books, 4th, 5th and 6th book is your reference book. So take these book as your reference book in case if you are having some doubts which is not covered by these top 3 books, you will go for the another book, and those books are known as reference. So this is all about today's lecture. If you have any queries and doubts, please let me know. Thank you very much.